Hi, my name is Mike Claron. I'm an engineer on the Android development team. Android is an open software platform for mobile development. It is intended to be a complete stack that includes everything from the operating system through middleware and up through applications. Now I'm going to focus in detail on a few of the APIs that I think provide fertile ground for innovation. The first is the location manager. This is a set of APIs that allows you to get geographic information. It will let you find out your current location, and it will also let you register to receive notifications if you get close to something interesting. So you can actually register, an intent with the location manager that will be fired when you get close to a point that you specify. And that lets you do things like be notified when you get close to one of your friends, or it lets you be notified when you get close to, say, an ice cream shop that has particularly good ice cream in it. And so that's a kind of interesting, innovative application that this kind of API enables. The location manager will use GPS if the device comes equipped with GPS. If it doesn't, it will make do with whatever information is available. That might be getting information from cell tower IDs, or if there's a Wi-Fi network that has geographic location information in it, we'll use that information to try to at least narrow down where you are. While building applications for the Android platform, we found that it was useful to have an always-on data connection so that the server could send notifications to devices running the Android platform. It turned out that this is such a useful piece of infrastructure that we decided to package it up and make it available as part of the public framework, and that has been done by creating the XMPP service APIs. The XMPP service allows any application to send device-to-device data messages to any user who's running Android on their device. Now, that data can be whatever information makes sense for the application. So for a multiplayer game, that might be that I've moved my knight to a particular location or whatever makes sense for the game. But it could also be something else like geographic information. So with appropriate permissions and security, the user could send their location to their buddies so that their buddies could actually see where they are at any given time and plot that information on a map. Again, this works with any Gmail account, so any application can send this type of peer-to-peer messages without having to build any server infrastructure. The next API is one of my favorites. It's called the Notification Manager, and it allows any application to put a notification into the status bar. We use the status bar for things like SMS notifications, voicemail notifications, all of the typical things you'd expect to see on a phone. However, we make that same facility available to any application. And so that means that developers can have the same power to alert the user to interesting events as what have traditionally been built-in applications. This has a lot of benefits. First, it means that all notifications have a consistent presentation. Now, the way we do it in the UI, we have a visible preview of what the notification means. So if an icon appears in the status bar, you can click on it or touch it to make it active. So you can see a preview of what it means, which means you don't have to figure out what each of 30 different hieroglyphics means. Then if you want to act on that notification, you can simply touch on it and you'll be taken to whatever application is responsible for that notification. This allows a lot of really interesting scenarios. It means that applications can notify you of things like when an auction is ending, or if someone has invited you to be their friend on a social network, or if a bus is coming. And all of those notifications can have the same level of prominence in the UI as something like voicemail or the other built-in notifications. And finally, I'd like to take a minute to talk about the view system in Android. Android provides a really rich toolkit of built-in views, and you can use those to assemble your applications out of standard parts. So we provide things like a list view and a grid view, a gallery view. We provide all the standard widgets like buttons and checkboxes. And by combining those things, you can build your applications really quickly. We've also done a lot of work in the framework to support multiple input methods and multiple screen sizes and multiple keyboard configurations in the view system itself so that you don't have to worry about that in your application. So for example, our list views work with touch, but they also work if you want to drive them with a five-way D-pad. And that's just a built-in facility of the view framework. In addition to that sort of views, we also are introducing two really innovative views. The first is a map view. This is an implementation of the same map rendering engine that's in our maps application. But we decided to make that available as a view so that applications can have really tight integration with geographic data. So it's, of course, possible to always launch the map application to display a particular location. But what the maps view let you do is actually embed a map view in your application so that you can control it from your own code, so you can set it to a particular location, zoom in, zoom out, pan the map, control all of that from your own code to build whatever kind of application you want to build based on that. We've done something similar with the browser. There's a browser application that you can launch to display a web page, but we also have a web view that enables you to embed HTML content as a view in your application that you can then fill with whatever data makes sense for your app. Personally, what I'm hoping to see come out of the Android effort is the kind of innovation that comes from what I call the mashup effect. We really had two goals in mind when we set out to create Android. The first was to provide developers with a powerful toolkit for building new types of experiences. This toolkit includes things like the application framework, the view system, things like the maps view and the web view that you can embed in your application, device-to-device messaging through XMPP, location services, notifications, and all the other pieces of our API. But the second and more important goal was to be sufficiently open and extensible to allow these pieces to be combined in ways that we really haven't imagined yet. If you're interested in finding out more about Android, I encourage you to visit the developer site and download the SDK. In the SDK, you'll find a lot more documentation and sample code, and you'll also be able to try building applications of your own. There's also a developer group that you can join to find out more information, and I also encourage you to check back frequently because we'll be posting updates to the SDK as the platform matures. Thank you for watching.